Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Amity Blue. My name is Nazy, and today I'm filming another journal with me in my personal traveler's notebook journal. The layout that I'm going to be sharing with you today is actually on this trifold paper. It's actually the outer lining of a vintage book, which I thought was kind of cool to add, and I actually tipped it in after I constructed my journal. All I'm doing now is reinforcing the folds with some masking tape. I love doing this with old papers that tend to crack or break when you fold them. And now I'm going through my stack of papers, and I'm pretty much dedicating this layout to Project Life cards. I know I'm not the only one that has a stash and a pile of Project Life cards building up, because they have such beautiful designs, but sometimes if you're not into scrapbooking or project life, we tend to accumulate them. And I want to show you a more creative way that you can add project life cards into your journal. I'm going to be using them as pockets. So instead of using a project life card in the traditional way, as in a tip-in or just as a little journaling card, I am going to trim them down to about a square, a little bit smaller, and using them as little mini pockets. And the whole idea with this layout is how one can document a lot of memories into a single page. I know sometimes we tend to run out of space in our journals, especially in my case. I have only a couple pages left and I want to put a lot of memories in them. So this is a great way to get all of your memories, your ephemera, and document it just in one page. Prior to creating my pockets, I need to focus on the background. So here I'm taking, as always, you guys know I love using book pages and vintage book pages because they have that cream patina to them, and I like to use them as backgrounds for my journaling. I especially like doing this when I'm going to be adding a pocket or I'm going to be collaging on top of, but you don't have to use book pages. You can use whatever you'd like. Scrapbook paper, your own photos, your artwork, pretty much the sky's the limit when it comes to creating backgrounds. I know a lot of people love watercoloring for their backgrounds. It's just adding something in the background so you can see it peeking through the pages. And for this layout, I'm going to be decorating my Project Life cards with scrapbook paper and wallpaper. This is something that I love doing with Project Life cards that are a little bit too simple or sometimes might not fit the color scheme of your journal pages. I love taking the Project Life card and gluing it to paper. Super simple. It's probably something that you guys already do, but it truly changes the look of the card, and it kind of takes it from becoming a Project Life card to something more special. And for this particular pocket, this is a little mini pocket that I got from Tuesday Morning from a scrapbook ephemera pack, and I'm just decorating the cover so that it looks a little bit more intricate. And now I'm taking some vintage ephemera that I have from my ephemera stack. And I also get a lot of questions as to how one can incorporate traditional authentic ephemera, vintage, into our journals. Because sometimes I know we're scared to use it or we're scared to ruin it. And what I love doing is using them as collages or as backgrounds. Now I know sometimes this can be a little bit challenging since we want to preserve the ephemera or have it have its own place to stand out, but things such as vintage newspaper articles or sewing patterns, or that little scrap in the corner is a little piece of a vintage report card that is a scanned copy, not the real thing. I typically sometimes tend to scan my really old ephemera so that I don't feel that bad when I'm cutting it. That is also a really nice tip. And as you can see, when you layer on your collages, your pockets, your photos, it really adds more dimension to the background. I also really like to use some scraps of paper that have to do with the color scheme of the layout. So you don't have to use vintage ephemera if you don't have any on hand. You can use your scraps, which is why I always suggest not to throw them away, as a little piece of paper can always make the difference in the layout. And of course, adding some yellow washi on the bottom to hold that paper in place and to also match with the colors of that paper pocket. Now I'm going into my stash and I'm pulling out a replica or a mimic of vintage paper. This is actually a scrapbooking paper from Seven Gypsies, which is one of my favorite scrapbooking paper lines. I'm not sure if they're still producing paper, but they are definitely one of my favorites. And trying to incorporate a little bit more of some florals, as you know, during the summertime and spring, I really enjoy incorporating floral scrapbook paper and florals in general in the form of washi, fabrics, and anything else that I have lying around that has floral imagery on it. It's the colors, it's the time of the season, like the zombie song, time of the season. So now I'm actually going into my ephemera box, and I have this box right next to me that has little bits and pieces that I collect from my everyday life. Random things. I don't have a particular journal page or a time, place to use it. I just pick and grab from whenever I choose. And I have paint samples. These are actually paint samples that I saved from my color theory course that I created a long time ago. And I punched them out into circles. And I passed it through my sewing machine in a straight line on the edge of the paper to kind of give it a border on the edge. And I think it looked absolutely precious. It reminded me of like a French artistic kind of a vibe. Basically, I loved it. It reminded me of Skittles, of candy, of balloons, pretty much everything that makes me happy and into a little pocket. So now is the fun part. Now is when I can take my typewriter and create the tags or the titles for my pockets. And I decided to fast forward through it just because the typewriter is pretty vintage and it tends to move the camera a lot, and I didn't want to give you guys a headache, so I decided to just show you the finished typed words and phrases. If you have a typewriter or you want to print out stuff on, I think I'm signalizing not to throw away your scraps. But if you own a typewriter or you want to print something out on typewriter font to make your little labels, I suggest using random scraps of paper, obviously big enough to fit through your typewriter or big enough to fit through the printer. It gives it such a pretty aesthetic that captures the beauty of the vintage typewriter script, but in a modern way, which is my favorite style. Using vintage items when possible, or mimicking that vintage style, incorporating it in a modern way into your journaling to make it more eclectic. And as you see here, I am actually struggling a little bit with what to fill that little inner white circle of the card. I knew I wanted it to have a flower since my label said blooming, and the topic was I wanted to include a picture of myself behind that little pocket of myself blooming and how I've changed over the years. So I love using Maggie Holmes, as always. She is the goddess of floral ephemera, but I didn't really feel like it went into the aesthetic that I was trying to portray. And then I remembered I have this scrap of vintage wallpaper that I used, I think, a couple videos back in a folder, in a TN folder tutorial. I was also experimenting with using some vintage wallpaper border, but I think it was a little bit too small. As you can see, it looked a little awkward and a little wonky. So I really love how you're able to see my thought process and how sometimes the most important thing is to just go with the flow in regards to journaling. Don't stress over it. And I know this is an advice that I need to take time and time again, because when you're really in that mood, when you're in your mojo, that journaling mojo that we all know, we all love, when we reach that level of like euphoria, when we're like on a roll, journaling our little hearts out, and you get tons of layouts done, all of your writing is just going easily like butter on your page, and then you run into something. If it's either something that you wrote, something that you put into your journal, something that you used to decorate that just doesn't flow right with you, it's okay. Just leave it in or change it. It's not a big deal. And this is why I love creating these Journal With Me videos, is because you see my real thought process behind a page. How sometimes a page doesn't have to be that elaborate, and sometimes it can be. It all depends on you, your lifestyle, what you want to document. I know when I was a lot younger, I had more time to journal. I didn't have as many responsibilities. I didn't have to take care of my little puppy and myself and everything that is now currently in my life. So my journaling has definitely changed, and I love that. That is what I think is so important when we're looking through our journals, is seeing how our styles change, how our handwriting changes, how our ability to document our life just changes. And as you can see here, I'm actually struggling a little bit with where to place my label. If you notice, every single pocket has the label placed in a different position. The first one in the upper left-hand corner says blooming. The bottom one says happiness. The upper right-hand corner says happy. And the lower right-hand corner says gathering. So these are the four words that I decided to use. And I wanted to document a moment when I bloomed, a moment when I was happy, a moment when I was laughing my butt off, and a moment when I was gathering with my loved ones. These are four words that are really special for me, and I felt like this was the best way to journal about four different moments in my life, all on one page, or not even one page, half a page. I still have about another half to a quarter left to journal my little heart out. Now I am taking my little hole punch. It's a very tiny circular hole punch, and I'm making my own tag, as you can see here, a little mini tag that I can use to journal a little bit more on the back. This is something that I like to do when I have a scrap piece of paper, turn it into a tag. When in doubt, make a tag. I think if there's ever a journaling Bible, this is definitely probably not the first, but the second thing that should be included. When in doubt, when in frustration, when excited, make a tag. It'll always work out. Now I am taking some double-sided tape, some trusty double-sided tape. I actually purchased it from eBay. It's super cheap. I think it's $2 or $1 a roll. Definitely affordable, but it does take a little bit of time to reach you. Check out eBay, check out Amazon, and trim off the edges. And I'm actually going to be making my typewriter label into a little tuck spot. Double-sided tape is definitely a lifesaver. It's one of my favorite journaling tools. When I can't pass something through my sewing machine, I reach for double-sided tape. You can also use washi tape, except maybe in times when you don't want to cover up a design, double-sided tape is your best friend. And as you can see, I created a cute little tuck spot where I can place my little tag. Decided to add a little bit of twine to make it look a little bit more realistic, as we all want our journaling to look real and fresh and hip and fun. Basically everything that I wish to be. What I wish to be, I put into my journal. And I do think that when you see someone, when you truly get to meet someone, and if you have the possibility to look into their journal, I think you would be able to understand that person better, to see their personality onto paper. And I think that's sometimes something that is very hard for some people and very easy for others. In this amazing journaling community, we have a gift. We're able to put our personality onto paper, which is something that not a lot of people can do. So definitely don't take it for granted and feel happy that you have this amazing gift. Now, as you can see, I am finishing up the pockets, adding, of course, more double-sided tape to finish off the corners of the pockets. If you notice, every pocket has a different type of closure, as I like to call it. One pocket is an upward pocket, another one is a side pocket, another one is just a little slip-in pocket. As you can see, for this yellow multi-pocket, there's a mini pocket on the front, another pocket in the middle, and the final pocket on the back. I think I've said pocket about 50 times in this video, but needless to say, I absolutely adore when you can add secret little tuck spots in random places that people would not normally care to look. So these are perfect. I always say these are perfect for hiding away your special secret memories. Perhaps an emotional story when you're having a bad day. I love writing about it and putting it into pockets because it doesn't have to be out in the open, but you can still let it out and get it out of your heart. And now I am picking out my ephemera, my personal ephemera, pictures, little die cuts. little special paper fragments that I can use to journal on. Those little mini animation sticky notes are actually from a trip to this Japanese stationery store. I fell in love with them. I thought they were the cutest thing on the planet, and I'm going to use them to journal on. So definitely use those sticky notes that you get and collect from the Target Dollar Spot, or if you're into cute kawaii stationery. Those quirky, fun, cute little elements only enhance your journaling. And on this particular photo, as you can see, it's a paper photo, so it's not the best quality. It was actually in my traveler's notebook, but I decided to move it to here. I'm journaling about my little siblings. They are my heart. They're my soul. They are my best friends. Ever since I was little, I wanted siblings, and my parents waited 10 years. When I was 11 years old, I finally was blessed with a baby brother, and when I was 15 years old, I was blessed with a baby sister. So I got the best of both worlds. I have a sister and a brother. They are definitely my best friends, and no matter the 10-15 year age gap, we will always be able to joke around, and we will always be best friends. So definitely let me know in the comments below if you yourself have a big age gap between your siblings or a big age differences. I'd love to hear your stories. And now I'm going through the rest of my ephemera, filling out the pockets, deciding what should go where. I pulled out this really cute tag that I got from the Target Dollar Spot. I think it was like a gift wrapping set, and there were a couple of tags included in it a long time ago, and I'm journaling about my mother. In the happiness pocket, I want to journal about my mom and the time that I've been with my mom for all these years and for all of the years to come. I'm actually journaling in Spanish, and the end is kind of funny. I say that I love spending time with her. She is definitely my bestest friend in the whole wide world, and she is the best manager in the world as well. We always joke around that she is the manager to Amity Bloom. She always keeps me in line and motivates and helps me to keep wanting to grow Amity Bloom as a business. And on this little card up in the corner for the laughing portion of the pocket, I decided it would be perfect to include these cute little sticky notes as like little characters that are popping out of the page or peeping through the pocket. I did this in my planner and it just made me smile every time I opened it up. So I did it in my journal, and I would journal on top of the sticky notes, including simple things such as sticky notes, but placing them in a cute and quirky way that makes you happy and serves as extra journaling space. So it's a definite win-win in my book. And I believe we are finished with the entire journaling layout. You would have never guessed that those four little pockets came out of Project Life cards. And if you did guess just by looking at the picture, then you are a journaling genius. I really hope that you guys had as much fun watching the journal with me process as I had creating it. I really loved how you guys got to see the whole process, the before and the after. I really hope that you guys got some ideas as to how you can create different types of pockets with your Project Life cards that you have lying around. The next time you reach for your journal and you notice that you only have a couple pages left, I hope that you use some of the tips and tricks that I showed in this video to create a layout where you can document all of your memories in. So I hope that you guys have an amazing day filled with peace and love. And of course, I will see you guys soon. Bye-bye.